Welcome to a new video where I want to show you the brand new features of the new early access version of SaferShares 4.3.0.12. Probably because it's early access, it's an RC, we don't get to know or get more features in this. So there are only several new features. It's not like a big release, but lots and lots of bug fixes that help this new version. One of the most promising or most interesting thing is Android app support that has been updated to be more integrated into the system. So it is integrated now in the file manager. You can open up your files directly in Android applications, but also the sharing option is there. So if I have a nice photo like this, I click on the share button here and the share menu will come up and gives me now also Android applications, just like if I want to upload this file on box.com, on Reddit, or share it via KDE Connect to several devices like your computer, Linux computer, but also to Android phones or tablets, or I think since a few days also iOS devices. So this is a nice little addition if you want to do this. So sharing to Android applications is possible. It's possible to open up files with Android applications now without any big issue. And regarding this, also the Firefox web browser, for example, this one here, which is an Android application, had issues with copy and pasting and the integration between a copy something from the Firefox browser and pasting it into a native SaferShares app has been fixed as well, which is, I think, a very good addition. And then we have also new system security updates. So if I take a look here, you can see we have the 5th of September 2021 update here, Android 10, which is nice for those who run Android applications. And of course, the system image has been signed now, so applications that were complaining about a rooted Android device will not complain anymore, hopefully. And some memory optimizations also work in favor of Android applications to have less memory being used here. Then the mobile data works more reliable when AD is on and switching between the mobile and Wi-Fi or vice versa is more stable on Android applications. We have some browser enhancements as well. So if I go to the browser here, what we will see is here the new menu that we had last time already has now a little pill here. This pill allows us to just drag it down to get rid of the menu, which is, I think, very handy indeed. Also, I think they moved a little bit around some settings, like the do not track setting is now here under privacy. I think it was under clear browsing data before, which is a bit misleading. And we now have a new permission for the camera, I think, and microphone. That wasn't available before, though I couldn't test this out because all the websites that I tried, like Meet Jitsi, just was not working because it was complaining about a too old browser engine. The browser engine is still an older Gecko version. Then we have also the camera application and the email application that should start faster. So let's open up the camera application. That's still taking a while to load here for some reason, but they are now in the booster settings again, which should preload certain libraries and start email and camera application a lot faster. Then the gallery, I was already in the gallery. I don't have an H.265 file here, but H.265 or HEVC videos will play again. This was an issue before, and the media player also is working now if you call it from the file manager. So media indexing has been updated to tracker 3, which will allow you to have faster indexing of video files and of photos and also music files as well. The app isolation has been prepared. So there's a setting that you can set manually for all the apps to be isolated now. This is something, a step that will be coming with SaferShares 4.4, where then all applications will have app isolation enabled. Means that some applications probably need to be rewritten in a certain way, or not rewritten, let's say, just code needs to be added to work fine with the app isolation. And then we have for people who install the application the first time, this tutorial app that is here has now an X button, so you can really close it now or skip it when you also start the device for the first time. So it's not necessary to do some hidden pattern that was there before. you can just close it normally. Then the Xperia 10 Mark II, which I have running here, had issues with the predictive text support. So if you would write something in predictive text, would have like issues in certain languages. In my language, gladly no issue at all, but this has been fixed for certain languages as well. So if you have other languages, you have now the option to use predictive text without those issues. You can see the edge swipes are still a bit of a problem. I think this might or can be fixed in the future as well. And yeah, this is pretty much everything that has been changed in Surface OS 4.3. There's some new camera fixes that you don't really see in the camera when, let's go in the camera, this thing started a bit quicker. It's like we have this automatic mode here. This is almost always visible. So if I go into camera mode, but also in video mode, before we had like, I think it was turned off or something like this for camera mode. And when you're switching, now it is still there and you can still use it also on the various others other lenses. So this is nice, and yeah, a nice addition to this. There's a lot of preparation and fixes underneath there. One fix, for example, regarding the weather widget, this bar here that shows the difference in temperature was a bit more radical before. Now it's a bit more smoothened out. If you have only like changes from 8 to 7 degrees, for example, it's not just a radical going radically going down, but it's more smooth here, which is I think also a nice addition. Some other fixes have been improved as well. The overall performance should be good, and copy and pasting should be a lot better. Calendar has been updated as well, especially if you have Microsoft Exchange support. It should work better now. Yeah, and that's pretty much everything for the new Surface 4.3 release. So this is not a big release, I would say, more of a bug fix release and preparation for Surface 4.4 and maybe the next releases as well. You can get it if you are in the early access version right now. Otherwise, for people who have running version 4.2, this might be a very safe upgrade because not much has changed in regards to the UI. And yeah, more bug fixes, better Android support, good stuff. That's basically everything for this short little video. If you have some questions or if you think I missed some very important new feature in Surface OS 4.3, write it down in the comment section. That's everything for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Until the next time. Bye.